guys, and thank you so much for joining me. If you are new here, I'm Kat, and I usually talk about true crime, conspiracies, and all sorts of related things. This video, I think it's perfect for Halloween. And by the way, guys, happy Halloween. Yeah, I don't have anything Halloween-y, sorry about that. Okay, anyway, let's get started. But before we do that, just a quick disclaimer. All the information that I give you in today's video is already found in the public domain. I also don't mean to be disrespectful to anyone I'm talking about in the video. This is for entertainment and educational purposes only. Thank you. We are talking about mummies today. So please, if you are triggered by baby mummies, then I don't think that this is the video for you. Thank you so much. Okay, let's get into it. Rosalia Lombardo, an Italian child born on December 13, 1918, died due to pneumonia as a result of the Spanish flu less than 2 years later, on December the 6th, 1920. Her father, Mario Lombardo, was so grief-stricken that he asked an embalmer to preserve Rosalia's remains. In the Capuchin catacombs of Palermo in Sicily, lies her dead body in a wooden and glass casket. The heartbroken father of Rosalia asked the help of Alfredo Salafia to preserve his baby girl's body. It was so amazingly preserved that Rosalia's body is intact over 100 years later. It's considered one of the best preserved mummies in the world. The body of Rosalia is famous among other 8,000 bodies found in these catacombs under the Capuchin convent. Rosalia's dead body caught the attention of everyone as people noticed her eyelids move many times, seeming like she's blinking. The eyes slightly open and reveal the intact blue irises. She lies in the coffin, glass covered and on a wooden pedestal. She looks like a baby peacefully taking a nap, and although a blanket is placed over the coffin, the face is visible. Her curly blonde hair and the ribbon on it makes her look like she is just sleeping. Rosalia is nicknamed the Sleeping Beauty. Alfredo Salafia, a taxidermist and a skillful embalmer, mummified the dead body of Rosalia Lombardo with impressive skill, preserving her so well that even her internal organs were kept intact. A century has passed, but her corpse still looks like the little girl is just sleeping under the glass case of the casket. It's very difficult to look at the small body in the glass coffin and still not believe that she will wake up at any moment. Rosalia's skin still appears very smooth, as if it's made of porcelain. Her golden blonde hair is very neatly tied with a beautiful silk bow. In 2009, an MRI scan of the girl was performed to see the state of preservation of the interior of the body. The first 3D image of Rosalia revealed that all the organs in her body are perfectly intact even after so many decades. Her striking crystal blue eyes are also visible underneath the blonde eyelashes. Rosalia's gaze is something that has attracted onlookers to Palermo for 100 years. Thousands of visitors from across the world have come to see the girl, intrigued by the many reports that the eyes of the dead body are blinking. People witnessed her eyes opening slowly, and the eyes seemed to glisten due to the low light in the catacombs. These blue eyes, like the rest of her body, are remarkably intact. Not only are the visitors convinced the little girl's eyes blink, but many sequences of photos seem to confirm that her eyelids open and close a little. This mystery of blinking eyes and the well-preserved body is what makes Rosalia's mummy so fascinating. The blinking mummy's mystery became famous across the world. People were curious to know what was causing the dead body to blink. Some believed that some supernatural force was at work and that the mummy actually blinked. Many others believe the eyes might blink due to the temperature changes inside the catacomb, which made her eyelids contract and produce the blink-like effect. It was still a mystery until the curator of Capuchin Catacombs, Dario Piombino Mascali, proved a new theory. The Italian biological anthropologist was able to debunk the myths about Rosalia Lombardo. According to Piombino Pascali, the blinking eyes of Rosalia were just an optical illusion, caused when light from windows strike her eyes at different angles. The changing direction of the light through the day makes Rosalia's eyes seem to open and close many times. Piombino Mascali made this amazing discovery in 2009 after some of the workers in the museum moved her coffin, which caused her body to shift a little bit. The shifting of her body allowed Piombino Mascali to see her eyelids from a different angle. The anthropologist then realized that her eyes were actually never closed and it had only been a trick of the light that made them seem so. Not only was the eye-blinking mystery solved by Piombino Mascali, but he also managed to track down the embalming formula Alfredo Salafia used to preserve the body of Rosalia in such impeccable condition. In 1933, when the Sicilian embalmer passed away, he wrote down the secret formula of the preservation. Piombino Mascali, in trying to find out the formula, tracked down the living relatives of the embalmer. There, he found Salafia's surviving records. When he uncovered the embalmer's papers, he came across the document where the embalmer recorded all the chemicals that were injected in the body of Rosalia. The typical embalming process includes the complete removal of organs. The empty body is then filled with natron salts, which desiccate it. But on this occasion, Salafia did something different. He made a small puncture and injected a mixture of zinc salts, formalin, glycerin, and salicylic acid. The combination of these ingredients worked to preserve the body. The formalin wiped out all of the bacteria, and the salicylic acid helped in removing any fungi present in the flesh. Glycerin prevented Rosalia's body from desiccating or drying out. But the magical element here was the zinc salts, which gave Rosalia's body rigidity. The salts preserved her appearance perfectly, even preventing her nasal cavities and her cheeks from caving in. Rosalia's body is now preserved in a new glass coffin, which is designed to block the growth of fungi or bacteria. The glass case also protects the body from any effects of light. Piombino Mascali hopes that visitors will stop making any new stories about the little child mummy. And this is the end of today's video. This is really fascinating. It really is. And the fact that the embalmer changed the formula specifically to preserve her body inside and outside is just a proof, a living proof of the devotion the parents had towards Rosalia. And over 100 years later, everyone can still see Rosalia just as she was when she was alive. Thank you so much, guys, for watching today's video. Please do let me know in the comments below if you've heard of this before. And also, please make sure you just hit the thumbs up button on this video. It's free, it doesn't cost you anything at all to do so. In fact, it really helps with my channel. The more likes the video gets, the more YouTube will spread the video around on the platform. Thank you so much, guys, and have a happy Halloween. Take care. Bye.